The Kia Telluride, basically everyone's favorite three-row SUV, got some wicked changes for the 2023 model year. We'll tell you all about those upgraded features in this video and show you the goodies that you get in this brand new X-Pro package. Now, you have a lot of choice in the large family SUV segment, and this class alone includes the Honda Pilot, Hyundai Palisade, Subaru Ascent, Toyota Highlander, and Volkswagen Atlas. That's a lot of competition, but I'm about to tell you why this is the best of the bunch. Starting off with styling, when the Kia Telluride first came out, it had a pretty bold look, but for 2023, that got updated, and now it's even more bold. I mean, that's really saying something. One thing that's a little disappointing is Kia got rid of their signature rectangle amber lighting in the headlights. It just gave the Telluride like a really cool, distinctive look. But this is still a very easily recognizable vehicle on the road, and that big brash grille looks extra cool. So brand new for 2023 is if you get one of the higher trims of the Telluride, you can also add on one of two cool new packages. There's the X Line and the X Pro. Now with the X Line, you get standard all-wheel drive, a raised ground clearance, and these cool raised roof rails up here. Now this one is the X Pro, and that's the highest package you can go to, and it's a little bit of a step up from the X Line. With that one, you get these all-terrain tires, an off-road suspension, and extra towing capacity. Now the nice thing about Tellurides is that no matter which model you get, they're all pretty good in these areas. This is a really strong all-around SUV. It's just with the X-Line or the X-Pro, it takes it to another level. The rear of the Telluride also got new styling. It's the same basic design principles as before. They just ratcheted up the fake Tahoe, tough traditional SUV look, even though it's still a comfy family crossover at heart. Now, normally it'd be really easy to make fun of this kind of like dress up cosplay, but the Telluride looks good from all angles, so I don't really have a problem with it. Let me know what you think in the comments. Under the hood of every Telluride is a 3.8 liter V6 engine. And that makes 291 horsepower and 262 pound-feet of torque. And it's mated to an 8-speed automatic transmission. I'm really curious to see how that feels on the road because we just tested a Honda Pilot that's been redesigned recently, and that had a 10-speed automatic that I thought was one of its best features. Let's see how this one stacks up against it. Now, a lot of engines in this class are turbocharged. That's not the case here. It's a traditional V6, so you get traditional power, but you also get traditional, not so great gas mileage. In all-wheel drive forms, the Telluride gets 21 mpg combined. Now, you don't have to add premium, so that's a plus, but there are lots of more efficient options in the class. Pricing for base models of the 2023 Telluride start at just over $37,000 with destination. Now this particular one is the top SX Prestige trim, and we've got the top X Pro package. And it's also got some small additional extras like carpeted floor mats and this cool paint. So that brings this total vehicle out to a little over $55,000 and change. Now, that's a lot of money for a Kia, but remember, that's the very, very highest trim and the very highest package. Plus, when we get inside, I think I'll be able to show you why, in a lot of ways, it's worth it. To me, the interior of the Telluride is where this car really shines. And it's not just big, flashy features, it's basic stuff, like getting into the car. The Telluride has one of the flattest entry floors I can remember seeing on an SUV. There's basically nothing for you to step over. You can just slide your feet right in. And if you have trouble climbing up into modern SUVs, you'll know what I'm talking about. That's really helpful. There's also a lot to like about the seats in here. First of all, there's a lot of space, and then there's just a really nice, strong, supportive structure to these seats. They're not the cushiest in the world, but I really like what Kia has done to just give you support on the road. Speaking of seats, every Telluride except the very base model comes with heated seats in the front. And this particular one is heated and ventilated, not just in the front, but also in the second row. How cool is that? On this particular one with the SX Prestige trim and the X Pro package, you get premium leather, this really nice stitching, and because we got the X Pro package in here too, this X Pro embossing on the top. Let's talk about materials for a second. Remember, this is a Kia, but you wouldn't really know it if you're looking at this really soft material on the headliner, this genuine wood dash, and lots of soft touch leather. Even if it's not fully all the way genuine leather, everything just feels like a step up, a step elevated. And this is where the Telluride really separates itself, especially at this price point. Now, just recently, we were in a Honda Pilot that cost similar money and had similar running gear, but it did not feel like this inside. The Telluride has a special presence. There's an impressive list of features in every Telluride too. No matter the trim level, you get dual zone automatic climate control. And this one has controls in the back for rear passengers too. I also really like the button layout here. Kia didn't throw all the controls into the screen. You do get some physical buttons, but they're out of the way. They're not cluttering up the place and they're really easy to find. The climate controls are sensibly placed and really easy to use. This is just a convenient thinking vehicle. Also, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto both come standard on every Telluride. However, there's no wireless option. At this price? What's up with that? Let's talk about the screens. For 2023, every Telluride comes standard with a 12.3-inch touchscreen. Now, 12.3-inch is basically the industry standard for big and looks nice before you get into like obnoxious 13-inch or 15-inch territory. This is just a sensible, nice size where everything's easy to read. And crucially, in the Telluride, everything's easy to use too. Now, another competitor in this segment that does a good job at this is the Volkswagen Atlas. That's also got technology that just seems to work. The Honda Pilot's a pretty good example. And then I feel all of these are a step ahead of the Toyota Highlander and Subaru Ascent. Moving on to the other screens. Not every Telluride comes with this 12.3-inch screen. This is the digital driver information display, and it shows, you know, your speed, fuel economy, proximity to other objects when you're parking, stuff like that. So this is upgraded over what some Tellurides get, and it's a great looking layout. So if you're looking at a higher trim and wondering if it's worth it, it's definitely nice when you have it. Also, on the SX Prestige trim, you get a heads-up display projected onto the windshield. If you've used those before, they're really convenient for seeing your speed and other information without taking your eyes off the road. So speaking of convenient and safe, you can also press this button down here and the Telluride will display a bunch of camera angles around the exterior of the car so you can make sure you're not about to run into a wall, a pole, or a rock. Not that I've ever done that. Of course not. The new Telluride gets upgraded safety features pretty much across the board, but one of my favorites is the digital blind spot. So when you're driving and hit the turn signal, the car will project an image of your blind spot right here on the digital information display. What a cool feature, and it's great for peace of mind on the road. That is actually my favorite feature in the Kia Telluride. There's also a digital rear view mirror, which just shows you a camera view out of the back of your vehicle instead of the regular mirror. But if you prefer the mirror, you can just switch it back. Kia is basically showing off at this point. The back of the Telluride is not just for kids. Once again, Kia got the basics right. This is a huge door opening, and once again, there's basically nothing that you need to lift your feet over, so it's really easy to slide in. Then once you're in here, this has to be one of the best uses of space in the entire three-row SUV class. I mean, look at this legroom and headroom. I'm 6 feet tall, and there's just tons of space in here. Now, I'm not so hot on the seats. These captain chairs feel pretty flat, both on the seat bottom and the backrest, but they adjust really nicely, so sit back and take a little nap. I also really like some of the near luxury features back here, like this manual sunshade and a big expansive sunroof. And then here's a nice touch. There's an AC outlet for charging larger devices, USB-C ports back here for smaller devices, and those automatic climate controls that we talked about are right up here. More evidence that Telluride has the best use of space in its class. We put the second row seat at a comfortable position where I can sit in, and I still have enough room back here in the third row for my legs. My knees are not rubbing up against the back of the seat. Telluride really does a great job of prioritizing passenger space back here. But what about amenities? Well, there's still two cup holders on each side, one USB-C port, that one gets a speaker, and I get a little cubby. These windows are nice and big too. So even though I'm stuffed back in the third row, I don't feel constricted or claustrophobic. All the way to the back, let's talk about cargo space. Behind the third row of seats, the Telluride gets 21 cubic feet of space. Now that is definitely among the class leaders. It's more than a Pilot and more than an Atlas. As you can see, it's a big wide opening, and again, nothing to lift over here. So if you get anything heavy, you can just kind of push it on in. I also really like underfloor storage, and this is a great example of it. And there's a cargo cover here, so you can store it in there or take it out and put it over your stuff to keep it hidden. Of course, you get even more space by folding down the third row of seats. All you do is pull on this and push, and then you can do the same for the second row with this power button right here on this particular model. Now you do that to all the seats and you get 87 cubic feet behind the front row. That's really good, but the Atlas is better. If you fold down all the seats, you get 97 cubic feet of space. Behind the wheel of the 2023 Kia Telluride, this is just a nice place to be. I've put a lot of miles on Tellurides and long road trips, tons and tons of highway miles, and my favorite thing about them is they just settle into a speed and cruise in comfort. So let's see if there's anything different about the 2023 model that changes any of that. Now we're on a pretty windy road here, so I've got it in the smart driving mode. So that's going to change the car's characteristics based on how hard you're driving it. And so far that's working out pretty nicely. I think it does a good job of guessing what you want from the car, what you're looking for. And there's an emphasis on comfort in the Telluride. So it's not super rigid and sporty, but it's also not overly cushy. It's just a nice, smooth, composed ride most of the time. There's a little bit of like body movement back and forth, especially when you're going through some twisty, windy roads here. But it's more of in the way that you would expect from a big cushy crossover. If you're looking for something sportier, I think the Subaru Ascent is a good option. And the Volkswagen Atlas feels pretty sharp on the road too. Okay, let's get into the power. So this V6 engine has almost 300 horsepower, which is no slouch at all. And there we go, step on it. And there is plenty of muscle, even for a vehicle this large. But I don't think it's the smoothest power delivery in the class. Steering feels really good. I'm pretty surprised, actually, out on this canyon road. Telluride feels great to drive. But for the vast majority of people, you're gonna be commuting in this thing or spending a lot of time on the highway. And in those situations, the steering feels really relaxed and comfortable, almost luxurious. That's a good tagline for the Telluride, actually. Almost luxurious. I think it describes it really well. Brakes feel good, no issues. I'm not getting any grabbiness. I'm not getting any brick-like resistance. So this Telluride with the X-Pro package gets an off-road suspension. Now, I don't want to mislead you. This is not a 4Runner by any means. It's got a little over 8 inches of ground clearance to help you get through some mud and trails if you want. But this is still a soft on-road crossover. And even with an off-road suspension, I would treat it that way, primarily. Another strength of the Telluride when you're on the road is this upright seating position, big old glass windows and windshield and thin pillars. So you've got great visibility all the way around you. Now, the Telluride isn't a massive SUV. It's not like a Tahoe or an Expedition or anything like that. So the fact that they're able to have relatively compact dimensions and still give you fantastic visibility all the way around is a definite strength. So that is our look at the 2023 Kia Telluride. Let's go over some of the pros and cons. Positives first. This is an extremely versatile all-around vehicle. And for 2023, you now have the option of these cool off-road packages just to give it some extra flair and character. I also really like the technology in the Telluride. And that goes for everything. The screens, the safety equipment, that really cool blind spot camera. Kia just does a really tight job on that stuff. And then finally, the space inside the Telluride. Not just the sheer amount of it, but the usability, the thoughtfulness, the versatility that went into it makes this car really usable and easy, both for passengers and cargo. On to some negative points. Fuel economy is definitely on the lower end of this class, and the ride can be just a little bit jerky at certain points. Also, when it comes to cost, the Telluride isn't overpriced, but you're not going to find that Kia discount that you may have gotten used to in the past. That doesn't really exist anymore, but there's a ton of features stuffed into this car, so you are getting a lot for your money. And then third, they can be hard to find. Dealers sell out of Tellurides pretty quickly, you may have to get on a waiting list if this is really the car that you want. Other than that, cup holders are kind of small. Telluride just doesn't have a lot of weaknesses. Well, that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to click like and subscribe so you can see more videos just like this one. And if you'd like to read more about the Telluride and its competitors, click the link in the description below. See you next time.